Consider the following two statements. S1. If a candidate is known to be corrupt, then he will not be elected. S2. If a candidate is kind, he will be elected. Which one of the following statements follows from S1 and S2 as per sound inference rules of logic? We need to identify which of the following statement is concluded from these set of premises. Is it if a person is known to be corrupt, he is kind? Or is it if a person is not known to be corrupt, he is not kind? Or is it if a person is kind, he is not known to be corrupt? Or is it if a person is not kind, he is not known to be corrupt? This question has been asked in GATE 2015 set 2 for 1 mark. Let's dive into the solution now. Let's see, is candidate is corrupt, E is candidate will be elected, and K is candidate is kind. According to the statement 1, if a candidate is corrupt, he will not be elected. Simple, right? And according to the second statement, if a candidate is kind, he will be elected. If a candidate is kind, he will be elected. Now let's consider these options one by one. Option A, if a person is known to be corrupt, then he is kind. If a person is known to be corrupt, he is kind. Okay, now we need to use the idea of contradiction here. That is, we try to make all the premises true and conclusion false. Let C is true and K is false. Then only this conclusion will be false, right? If C is true and K is false, then we know that false implies anything is always true. And we need to take not E true, as not E cannot be false. If not E is false, then this premise becomes false. Let's take not E true. If not E is true, then E becomes false. These two premises are true, right? And our conclusion is false. And hence we can say that this argument is an invalid argument and option A is a wrong option, right? Let's consider the second option. If a person is not known to be corrupt, that is not C, then he is not kind. Let's take not C true and not K false. If not C is true, then C will be false. If not K is false, then K will be true. K is true, then we have to take E true. And if E is true, then not E will be false. These two premises are still true, right? And our conclusion is false. Hence, this particular conclusion is not followed from these two premises, and we can say that this argument is an invalid argument. Let's consider the third option. If a person is kind, he is not known to be corrupt. Let's make K true and not C false. If K is true and not C is false, that means C will be true. If K is true, then E cannot be false, right? E has to be true. And if E is true, then not E will be false. This premise is true, but this premise becomes false, right? Hence, we cannot make all the premises true and our conclusion false. This is not possible. Hence, we can clearly say that option C is the correct option. You can check option D also. If a person is not kind, he is not known to be corrupt. And you will find that you would be able to make all the premises true and conclusion false. And hence, option D is also not a correct option for these set of premises.